Good morning and welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. I'm coming to you from East Warren, East Warren Avenue at Outer Drive. I'm going to get back to why we're here in a minute. Let me just bring you up to speed on a couple crazy national issues. I just finished reading Michael Wolff's book on President Trump, Fire and Fury. I urge you to read this book and be afraid, be very afraid. If only 25% of what's in this book is correct, there's enough reason to be scared. I don't know how we elected such a man as our president, but it's bad, ladies and gentlemen. It's bad. And it got even worse last week when he is quoted by Dick Durbin as saying that, why are we protecting these people from S-hole countries? Why are we bringing them into our country? S-hole countries, I can't say the expletive that goes along with it. And it was confirmed that he said it by Dick Durbin. He has since denied it. President Trump has since denied it. We're in a dangerous state, ladies and gentlemen. We're in a dangerous state. We have a new tax bill that has gone through that is going to hurt the poor. We have new changes that are coming down the road to entitlements. It's going to be rough all over. And, you know, people say Detroit has come back. They say Detroit has come back, but my barber, you may see my hair is a little bit long. The reason why it's a little bit long is because my barber actually got robbed in Rivertown, right by the brand new 7-Eleven on East Jefferson. Right by the brand new Bucharest on East Jefferson. He gets robbed at 8 o'clock at night. You know, Detroit has not come back until it stops becoming the Wild Wild West. In that case, it was the Wild Wild East. There's so many of our people here that are hurting, ladies and gentlemen, and so few resources to actually help them out. Today, I'm going to introduce you to a young man that stems that tide, that is working to stem that tide, a young man that doesn't have the big support of the Community Foundation, the Skillman Foundation, the DTE Foundation, whatever Quicken does in terms of their philanthropy. He doesn't have that. He's doing it all on his own. If you can see in the background, they're cots. They're cots because people sleep here in what was once a computer store on East Jefferson. Ladies and gentlemen, excuse me, East Warren, Dave just reminded me. I'm sorry. I'm still thinking about my barber getting robbed. I'm sorry. On East Warren. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jerry Boykin. Jerry, I'm impressed with what you're doing here.
Thank you.
What is this? What are these cots for?
Well, these cots are for people living on the streets. I mean, it was so cold last week that I was sitting at home with my son and I was feeling guilty because I had a warm house. Mm-hmm. And I said, I have to do something as far as helping the homeless because people were dying on the streets and they didn't have any place to stay. So I came over to this building, and we just started working. I had a lot of construction work to do to it to get it suitable for people to stay here for the night. Mm-hmm. And people just started donating cots and pillows and blankets and food and, I mean, you name it, coats. And these are just people who have followed me on Facebook and Instagram. They see what we do every week as far as feeding the homeless and different things we do in the community, giving cars away to families for Christmas, fixing up houses.
But we're going to get into other stuff in a minute.
Okay.
You don't strike me as a particularly wealthy person, Jerry.
I don't.
How are you pulling all this off?
Well, I'm not wealthy. Actually, when I started this, you know, when God put it in my heart to do it, I had $60 in my pocket. Mm-hmm. And I said, well, I don't have the means to do it, you know. Mm-hmm. And then he reminded me, well, you didn't have the money to give the cars away for Christmas either. Mm-hmm. You didn't have the money to fix up the house that you gave away.
You gave away cars at Christmas?
Gave away cars at Christmas.
We're going to get back into that stuff. Okay. When we come back, Jerry, let's start with the cars.
Okay.
Move to the houses and work our way to a warming center.
Okay.
A non-philanthropic funded warming center. Man, this is odd. This is odd. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with Jerry Boykin, and we're going to talk about giving away cars, rebuilding houses, and a warming center on East Warren. We'll be right back.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team One, only at the DMC.
Welcome, Judge Mathis. Thanks for coming to share an important message with the Wayne County taxpayers.
Well, thank you for allowing me to help. You know, most of my life, I was a resident of Wayne County, and so I'm here to help because Treasurer Shabree wants to work with Wayne County homeowners to keep families in their homes and prevent foreclosure.
If you're having trouble making your property tax payments, let us know. We have many resources to help.
Take the first step towards staying in your home by going down to the Wayne County Treasurer's Office on the fifth floor of the International Building in Greektown.
Stop by today to learn more about our payment plan and especially the newly extended interest rate reduction program.
Already in a payment plan? It's important you stay in good standing.
Making property tax payments is now easier than ever. We have placed payment kiosks in Rite Aid stores and community centers across the county. We've also added kiosks in our offices. Contact us at 313-224-5990 or email us at taxinfo@waynecounty.com.
Every year, DTE Energy helps its business customers save about $40 million on their energy bills. We perform over 1,800 free on-site business energy consultations and provide hundreds of money-saving incentives. Why? Because we're committed to helping Michigan's businesses and its people thrive. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
What first sparked your curiosity? Drove you to learn more, to be better, to achieve things, and go places you couldn't have imagined before? At WCCCD, you can discover or rediscover your spark for learning and find your path to your best life. Want more? Start here. Register today.
Groundbreaking. Life-saving, history-making, the new DMC Heart Hospital, summer 2014. The beat goes on.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. I'm here coming to you from East Warren Avenue, and my guest is Jerry Boykin. Who is he? He's just a guy that wanted to fix things, wanted to make things right. He's not rich. He's not even getting any philanthropic help. You mentioned our last segment, you gave away cars. Let's talk about that.
Well, the organization started. We Are One Community Unity.
Is that a 501c3?
No.
Okay.
No, we're we're a nonprofit, but we're not 501c3. Mm-hmm. The reason why is because when we started helping the homeless and people in need, it was just so much red tape people had to go through. When they needed a place to stay, you got so much paperwork to fill out. When they need a car, when they need assistance, you have to go through too many hoops and jump too many hurdles. So if someone's hungry, here's some food. If someone needs a place, here's a house.
This is specifically because of that, those regulations and all. This is specifically why I'm not giving the address here.
Oh, right.
Because I don't trust the Buildings and Safety and Engineering Department of the City of Detroit not to descend upon you. Mm-hmm. So they just have to figure it out.
Okay.
Continue, Jerry.
So, I started feeding the homeless out the trunk of my car. And we would feed 100 people. Every week, for 7 years, we haven't missed a week. So we went from 100 to 200 to 300 to 400 to 500. And just people started coming and helping, family, friends, neighbors, people on social media that I would meet. And the movement is, I'm a blessing, like you see on the shirt. Mm-hmm. So, every day when I wake up, God blesses me to be a blessing to other people. And, that's just my life's mission.
And you have heat
in here.
Contagious.
Well, we just got the heat on. It was an outstanding bill of $2,800, and I made some calls. Called Maureen Taylor, a good friend of mine, and she helped as far as getting the heat on. And my neighbor here at iFix Detroit, Rob, he paid $1,000 towards the bill, and really helped out a lot with this building here. He's the reason for it, yeah.
Let's start with the cars.
The cars.
Well, tell me about you, Superman, giving away cars.
Well, it's not me. I'm not doing this myself because, like you said, I'm not rich. Mm-hmm. So it's everybody coming to help people that can't help themselves. Mm-hmm. And I'm just pushing the movement, you know. So two Christmases ago, people were saying, well, Jerry, you feed the homeless and you help people so much. What are you doing for Christmas? And I said, well, I don't know. It's only a week away. I wanted to do something really crazy and exciting, like give a car away. Mm-hmm. And the lady said, well, if you do, I have $100 towards it. So I went home and made a post. But before I could even get home, I had people calling me and donating money to the car. So what it is, people just donate $10, $20, $5, whatever. And we get the cars from Henderson Automotive, because that's where I keep the food truck that we use to feed the homeless. Mm-hmm. So he supplies the cars. We get the cars at a really, really good deal. And then we surprise a family in need, and we all give the cars away for Christmas. So just
one,
trying to change
one
someone's
little part
life.
To that, though. Mm-hmm. What about the insuring that car?
Well,
if a family's in need, how can they how can they afford the insurance in Detroit?
Well, you know, it's high, definitely, but we help it as much as we can.
So you help with the insurance?
We help out as much as we can. The lady we gave the car away, you might have seen on the bus. Mm-hmm. We surprised the lady at the bus stop with the car, and she didn't have the money to get the plates and the tags, so we helped her with that. But we just do whatever we can because, like I say, we're not funded. The only way we can do this is by people donating and helping out, you know, with what we're doing. So that's how we do it.
How do people donate?
Well, you can go to imablessing.org. You can donate there. You know, we have Cash App now. That's been really helpful and easy to do. Mm-hmm. So the Cash App is actually the phone number, 313-744-3038, and you can go there and donate, and I can get things that we need as far as for the warming center, for the food truck, for we have another house that we're going to fix up and give away, and I'll tell you about the first one too.
Oh, I want to hear about the houses in our mm-hmm. next segment.
Okay.
I also want to hear. I mean, you're breaking a lot of the paradigms of. Well, you said you're 40 years old.
Yeah, I don't tell my age, but I'm somewhere in that area.
Okay. You're somewhere in the air for age 40. Yeah. What we see in the first 6 minutes of the news mm-hmm. are black men screwing up. Mm-hmm. And here you are hanging it all out there for people.
Yeah.
You know, people donating. And you're not, I mean, you're a good guy.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with more from East Warren and Jerry Boykin. We're going to hear about those houses.
Okay.
If you or a loved one needs help, call the Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority at 1-800-241-4949. The Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority is your provider for services when you need a hand. We provide services for your whole family in substance abuse, autism services, and parent support. We are there to help with people suffering from depression, anxiety, and those with developmental disabilities. We can assist you with a variety of your mental health care needs. Housing placement for the homeless, job placement, and prescription coverage. As the largest mental health care organization in the state, it is our job to care for you from the neck up. We are the source for all your mental health needs. We are there for you and your entire family. Call us at 1-800-241-4949 or visit our website at dwmha.com.
Hello, I'm Dr. Shauna Diggs, and welcome to Cosmetic Dermatology.
As Michigan's leader in comprehensive skin health and rejuvenation, board-certified dermatologist Dr. Shauna Ryder Diggs and the entire Cosmetic Dermatology team take a caring, customized approach to skin care. The Cosmetic Derm team effectively treats skin diseases and autoimmune diseases, such as lupus. State-of-the-art laser technology is utilized in hair removal, tattoo removal, and skin peels. To learn more, visit our website, Cosmetic Dermatology, where science and beauty meet.
Always there when I need it. You could just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. And the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal with him. He was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Rollister.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he will definitely fight for you.
At the Turkey Grill, turkey is what we do. So if you want the juiciest and easiest turkey for your holiday dinner, get your whole fried turkey now and relax on the big day. The Turkey Grill is open early every day with their $1.99 breakfast special, turkey sausages, hash browns, and toast. And they always have delicious turkey breast dinners, carved turkey breast sandwiches, turkey ribs, turkey wing bites, and juicy turkey burgers.
At the Turkey Grill, turkey is what we do.
The Turkey Grill on Woodward, four blocks north of West Grand Boulevard. Call 313-872-4624.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from East Warren Avenue on Detroit's East Side. My guest is Jerry Boykin, and you know, I haven't met a person that's just trying to pull it up on his own with the help of people without the big foundations. Oh, Jerry, we've talked about the cars. Let's talk about the houses.
Houses.
What are you doing? Are you really rebuilding houses and giving them away?
We are.
How are you doing that? Last person that did that was a guy named Anthony Kellum.
Wow.
And that didn't work out so well for him.
Wow. We actually friends on Facebook. I guess some seeds were planted because I remember seeing
him remember
do
when
that
he gave
some years
but
ago.
But it was not, I'll just leave it at that.
I didn't hear about all of that. But
yeah, we'll just leave it at that.
I guess I was inspired by him a bit. Mm-hmm. And now that you talk about it, but we have a house that we're actually getting ready to do now, another one, not too far from here. Mm-hmm. But the first house was donated by Dan Boatner. And he had a house that was in bad shape, and he said, Jerry, I got a house. If you know somebody, if we can fix it up, you know, we can be a blessing to someone. So we started working on it. It's in really, really bad shape. And like I say, I started with no money, just started working on the house, and I did some Facebook posts, Instagram posts. And people just really came out and helped with that project. So,
but what's more interesting are the people that you have coming out.
Always good people. It's people that I don't even know.
I know a suburban young lady, mm-hmm. African American, and I call her after breakfast on Saturdays. I eat breakfast with my family. I said, "What are you doing?" She says, "I'm on my way to help rebuild the house. We're going to give a house away." Mm-hmm. I'm like, "Come on, mm-hmm. come on."
Yeah.
You know, I couldn't believe her.
Yeah.
You know, because I've never seen her community involved at all, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. and yet she's raving about this darn house. That's she's the reason
fun.
I'm here today.
Yeah, we make it fun. We make it exciting. It's a blessing to be in a position to be a blessing to someone else.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of times people are going through things on their own,
mm-hmm.
And it's easier to help someone else instead of worrying about your own problems that you're going through.
Mm-hmm.
So we bring people together, and it becomes like a family. Mm-hmm. You know, so the house that we fixed up, I had people come in to redo the wood floors.
Mm-hmm.
I had people donating granite countertops,
mm-hmm.
brand new cabinets, TVs, furniture, toiletries, everything, I mean, that you could think of, and paint. And we put this house together. And when people saw it, they couldn't believe where we were.
Mm-hmm.
So we surprised the lady with this house, and she didn't even know it was for her because I had her at the house working on it.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you had her mm-hmm. rebuilding her own house.
Her own house, and she had no idea it was for her.
Mm. What about the utilities? What about the insurance?
The utilities, insurance. Right now, Mr. Boatner, he had been taking care of the utilities. So what we did was she lived in the house for free for 6 months, and then all she had to pay was the DTE, the insurance, and taxes came to about $350. So she has a fully furnished house, and everything in it is brand new. New furnace. We had a brand new furnace and air conditioner put in. So all she has to pay is $350 a month. Mm-hmm. And I mean, that's a blessing because I know what my bills are.
Do you do any financial literacy training?
Well, we do have people that can do it, but we just got the building. We were blessed with this building. And now we're doing this warming center, so I'm putting some things, you know.
Well, you mentioned the warming center. Mm-hmm. We're going to take a break in a couple seconds. When we come back, we're going to talk about this warming center.
Okay.
I mean, because you've got people like Thaw, you've got Dabo, you've got all these big names.
Mm-hmm.
DTE, you know, sponsors all these things. But you guys are sitting here doing a warming center on your own.
Yeah.
And I want to hear how you did it from A to Z. I'm still looking. You got nice cots and everything here, nice storage bins and everything.
Yeah, thank you.
I couldn't sleep here.
You could.
Man, you ever seen a fat man on a cot? It's called hitting the floor. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with Jerry Boykin.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team One, only at the DMC.
Every success story starts with a spark of curiosity, of wanting more. Wayne County Community College District has more than 120 academic and career training programs and support to help you every step of the way. From registration to financial aid to career placement, find your spark and get on a path to your best life. Register today.
Every year, DTE Energy helps its business customers save about $40 million on their energy bills. We perform over 1,800 free on-site business energy consultations and provide hundreds of money-saving incentives. Why? Because we're committed to helping Michigan's businesses and its people thrive. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
We got our dream home at a dream price.
It's buildingdetroit.org.
This was the house that was meant to be.
We actually have a house. I mean, this is our house.
Register to bid, attend an open house, buildingdetroit.org. Welcome home.
Now, see more homes for sale than ever at buildingdetroit.org, including Own It Now homes, online at prices from $1,000. Just go to the Own It Now page at buildingdetroit.org.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're coming to you from East Warren Avenue in Detroit. My guest is Jerry Boykin, and we're at his warming center. It's not funded by the big foundations. It's just here. Jerry, why? How?
Well, I mean, the love of the people who have donated to so we can do this. I mean, because I couldn't do it on my own, and I don't do it by myself. That's why the organization is called We Are One, mm-hmm. Community Unity, and that's just what this is showing right now.
In the age of Duggan in Detroit, the rebirth downtown, mm-hmm. that is not hitting East Warren, okay? It's declined in the, 28 years that I've lived near here. Mm-hmm. It's declined. It's gone down. Why here?
Well, I guess this is where God wanted me to be, because I'm a West Sider. I don't come on the East Side for too much of anything. Mm-hmm. And when I was blessed with this building, I said, wow, the East Side, this is where, mm-hmm. you know, I'm going to be. I said we have to do a warming center or something here to help the people over in this area, mm-hmm. because we do so much in the downtown area and West Side. So I guess I'm just branching out. You know, when God can trust you, he'll increase your territory. And that's what's happening right now.
Detroit is supposedly rebuilding, though, Jerry. What kind of men and women come in here?
Well, I had a gentleman who had been riding his bike for a week. And he had been living in gas stations, sleeping there at night. And he said, you know, his feet was wet, was cold, and he was just tired. He wanted a night, you know, a place to sleep for the night. Mm-hmm. So when he got here, he wasn't here 5 minutes, and he laid on the cot, took his socks off, and I gave him some new socks and a flannel and a coat, and he laid down within 5 minutes, and he was snoring. You know, and I posted it on my social media.
You posted him snoring?
Snoring. Yeah, he was sleep knocked out, and he was covered up, and I just posted him snoring. And, you know, it's a lot of things we take for granted, like snoring. And to see him snore, that meant that he was in a place where he was comfortable and he could get a good night's sleep. And, you know, we take that for granted, you know, being able to sleep in our beds. But I was thankful that people had all chipped in and we were able to get these cots, these pillows, these blankets, you know, so he could get off the streets and be able to sleep here.
So how many people are sleeping here?
Well, we had this guy here. I actually went and got them from the rescue mission. We just got it up and running maybe 3 days ago. Mm-hmm. And I had a young gentleman who was living in his car. And He didn't have a place to stay. So when he heard me talking to the other guy, he said, man, I want to come too. So he was here. You know, we brought him in. We got him some hot cocoa. We got him some soup. We had food. We had people prepare dinner, you know, and things like that. So
what's tripped out to me about all this is my church is involved in what's called the Rotating Shelter Program, where they take the homeless for a week. They let them sleep there for a week and feed them dinner, feed them meals, and then put them out during the day. And that's 1 week a year.
Okay.
But you're talking about doing this every week.
We're doing this every week right now.
But you don't have a congregation of over 5,000 people.
No.
And you're doing it every day.
We're doing it every day.
Dude. Okay. How does everybody else step up? How do people donate to this operation? How do they donate their time? Because everybody doesn't have money. How can they come and help you rebuild a house? How can they come and help you operate this warming center?
Well, I mean, you can go to the website. You can call. You know, I love to talk to people and meet new people because this has been great to meet a lot of people and find out the different things they've been through to lead them to want to help. You know, I have a lot of wonderful stories that I've heard. So the website is imablessing.org, like the shirt. And the phone number is 313-744-3038. You can call. You can come on down to the warming center. We need volunteers to come stay at the warming center, you know, watch the people. We play checkers. We play games. Really just the conversations that people need, because all day long people are telling them to get away from here. And they don't get to have conversation and talk to people. So
how do they follow you on Facebook so they can find out more, see more people snoring?
On Facebook is Jerry Boykin. That's my personal page. Or We Are One Community Unity, Inc. You can follow me on Facebook. And Instagram, it's W-E-R, the number one community unity.
Okay.
Yeah. And I actually just started a Twitter. So that's imablessing_org. I got two tweets up now.
All right. So, yeah. Jerry, I want to thank you, man. You're
thank
a real
you.
Inspiration.
Thank you.
And you actually taught me something today.
Wow.
Yeah, I had a young lady that snored like a train, you know. I said, like, now I know she was just comfortable because she felt she could snore. Ladies and gentlemen, have a great week.